Hola, hola. My name is Ramon, cosmetic formulator and sunscreen fanatic, and today we're talking about my favorite sunscreens for dry skin. But make sure you hit that subscribe button because for the next couple weeks, I will be uploading some of my favorite sunscreen recommendations based off specific skin types and concerns, and I don't want you to miss those. Getting into it, note that I will have the specific review videos for each individual sunscreen linked down in the description box. I will not be going into like a lot of tea about each one, so if you want the full tea, check out each of the videos. Starting off, first one I'm going to talk about is from Cott. It's their Flawless Complexion Sunscreen. This is a really good sunscreen. It's really cute. It's a fairly widely inclusive sunscreen considering it is a mineral option. This one to me was good, but not great because I found this was really radiant, really emollient on my oily skin. And so I'm like, oh, this is gonna be great for dry skin. It does have bismuth oxychloride, which for some more sensitive skin individuals could be a little bit of a question mark, in which case I would recommend their sensitive skin version of this, which will leave a white cast and isn't the most inclusive across a wide skin tone range. But Cott sunscreens, really great options. Greatly enjoyed every single one I've tried, so definitely worth checking out. But this one specifically, if you have dry skin, great option. And next is one I don't have, and one that I didn't have the best personal experience with, but looking at it very objectively, I'm like, this is not a bad sunscreen. It's just not meant for me necessarily. And that is from Pipette. It's their SPF 50 sunscreen. The tea with that one is just, it's a really moisturizing oil-based sunscreen and that does not work for my skin type. For me, that did leave a white cast as a result of that. But that being said, I know a lot of individuals with deeper skin tones and drier skin types who actually had a decent experience with that sunscreen. And I think that's due in large part just to the vehicle that the sunscreen is in. It's a very moisturizing vehicle that's great for dry skin types. And if that works for you, you might have a much easier time working those filters into your skin than I did. So if you're looking for a mineral option, that is very affordable. It's available at Target, like $15. That is an option I actually would recommend you checking out. It's also a really good dupe for the Biosan sunscreen if that one is just too expensive for you. Getting into some chemical options, first and foremost, I have the Black Girl Sunscreen SPF 30. It's the original Black Girl sunscreen. This one is a really good cost-effective option. It's technically for face and body, and that's why you get a lot of products out of it. It's like $16. And this one is very moisturizing. It's a lot of oils up in this. That in itself was a reason I didn't love it. It was just too heavy for my skin type. But that being said, this is a really good heavy duty sunscreen. It is water resistant, sweat resistant, and it is a very good daily sunscreen SPF. It's SPF 30, broad spectrum. If you want something a little more heavy duty, their kids version is a really good one. But specifically, this one is, I think, a better option for dry skin because it is nicely moisturizing and has a lot of emollient oils in it. A very similar option, an arguably Black Girl sunscreen sister. This is from Bondi Sands, with an Australian brand. It's their Face SPF 50 Plus fragrance-free option. And this pretty much checks a lot of the same boxes that the other Black Girl sunscreen one did. It's moisturizing, it's very emollient, it's very cost-effective. This one here in the UK is £7. I don't know what it translates to in USD. And it is also very water-resistant. Something worth noting is that this says it's 4 hours water-resistant, based off more Australian claims. In the US, I think we have different metrics for measuring that, but this is very water resistant, very heavy duty. For me, I just found this to be really moisturizing on the skin, so much so for my oily skin. But looking at it objectively, this is a very similar texture, feel, and experience to the Black Girl sunscreen. So I'll be looking for a little bit more of a cost-effective option worth checking out as well. And then next, I got Miss Fenty Skin, the Hydra Visor. This is a beautiful sunscreen. Objectively, I want to love this so much because it makes the skin look beautiful and supple and radiant, but this is just a little bit too rich for me and my oily skin. Can I make it work? Yes. Do I make it work? Yes, because I love wearing this because it smells so good. And there's just something about this, it just makes the skin look amazing. I can't explain it. I don't know what it is. It's literally magic. But this is just one that, especially on like a really hot day, does not work. It runs and gets in my eyes. If I set it, especially on the eyes, I don't have the issue, but it's just a little bit too rich for me. And so with that alone, I'm like, this is a great option for dry skin just because it is a very moisturizing texture. So if you don't mind fragrance, definitely check this one out because you will smell delicious. And then next I have the Thank You Farmer Sun Project Water Sun Cream. Kind of a very similar experience to the Fenty Skin one in terms of how it looks on the skin and feels on the skin. It's a very moisturizing texture that it leaves your skin like a really nice, supple, radiant glow, even having oily skin. It was just a little bit too far on the edge of being too emollient for me. But as a Korean sunscreen, it has a lot of things we love about Korean sunscreens in terms of like anti-inflammatory ingredients and as well as antioxidants. So if you have dry skin, it's a really good option to check out if you like a lot of the formulation concepts of Korean sunscreens. This one doesn't have alcohol, but it does have fragrance though, so do note that. And next is another really heavy duty sunscreen option. This is from Avène. It's their Avène Intense Protect SPF 50 Plus sunscreen. New launch, new UV filter in this, very innovative. So you're getting really good broad spectrum, high photoprotective values from this. It's really water resistant as well. And it's also really emollient. That in itself just did not work for my skin. But if you have dry skin, this is probably going to be a godsend for you because it's richly moisturizing. This is a great option if you're going out and you want like a heavy duty sunscreen for like a heavy duty UV index day, or you just want a heavy duty sunscreen for every day. I don't know, live your life, boo. I know specific dry skin individuals who did really enjoy this. So just notes, if you want a really moisturizing, very heavy duty sunscreen, this is going to be a really great option. This is technically only available in the UK and the EU right now, but if I do find some US shipping websites, I will have that in the description box as well. Next is a really hydrating sunscreen from Essentry. This is their hyaluronic acid watery sun gel. Let's see what this one is. That this has 8 different molecular weights of hyaluronic acid, so you're getting like really deep, very profuse hydration with this, which is really good if you have dehydrated dry skin. And so with this, you're really targeting that hydration quality in your skin, really making sure you have good hydration. But this is also nicely moisturizing. That's going to help lock it in as well. It's not as emollient and as rich as some of the other ones I talked about today. So if you want something more lightweight, maybe to sit on top of another moisturizer you do enjoy a lot, this is something I would definitely consider. Really beautiful texture, really beautiful finish, and generally very affordable. Depending on where you get it, it's about $13-$15. This is a really great pick, specifically again for that hydration benefit. I just love plump hydrated skin. And then next I have another Korean option. This is from Make Prem. It's a UV Defense Me Blu-ray Sun Gel. This actually is also very similar to Fenty Hydrovisor. It's just really nicely emollient on the skin, gives your skin a nice supple radiance to it. You look very smooth, you look very dewy, but it's very rich, it's very moisturizing. And with that, that's why I was like, this is not for oily skin. But on dry skin, this would be a beautiful option. But again, this is a very nice, lightweight Korean sunscreen. It's gonna give you nice moisturizing benefits as well as all the other things we love about Korean sunscreens. So definitely check it out. This is a cult classic Korean sunscreen. Make Prem is just one of those brands that everyone loves. And the next two are gonna be Japanese options. First one I have is from Verdio. This is their Verdio UV Moisture Essence. This is a nice gel cream texture that's richly moisturizing on the skin. So it goes on nice, lightweight, very thin, but you definitely get a very good impact of those moisturizing benefits. Really nice texture because it's a Japanese sunscreen, and it's actually generally very affordable. I think this was like $7, but it's just a lot for my oily skin. And so if you have dry skin, you love Japanese sunscreens, you definitely want to try some out. This is a really good option, especially just getting very good moisturization out of this. This is also jam-packed with some really great antioxidant benefits and anti-inflammatory benefits as well. So this is one of those sunscreens that I would recommend if you want like a one-and-done product just to get a lot of things out of your skincare at once, just because there's a lot of great benefits in this one. And then the last product I'm talking about today is from Suncut. It's their Aqualie UV Protect Gel. Similar to the Thank You Farmer and the Make Prem one, this one is a super lightweight gel texture that just packs a really good moisturizing punch. It's nicely emollient, it really locks in moisture and gives you a really good moisturizing benefit. It's rich, it's a little bit too rich for my skin. This definitely leaves me with a very good supple glow, but again, it's just a really good hydrating option as well. Similar to the Essentry, you get a lot of hydrating humectant benefits from this one. One of the things I love about Japanese sunscreens is that you do sometimes find packaging like this, a really nice generous pump bottle. It's 160 grams for like $12. So you get a lot of bang for your buck. And this is one where you can really put on a lot of this and it's not gonna feel heavy and greasy on the skin, even for me. But this is one that, because of that glow, because of that emollience, this is one I tend to favor for more dry skin types. And with that, those are my sunscreen recommendations specifically for more dry skin types. Let me know down below in the comment section, have you tried any of these and what your experiences were with them? Also, what are some of your favorite dry skin friendly sunscreens? Make sure you hit the subscribe button, notification bell, so that you know when I post more skincare, sunscreen, and Fenty related content on my channel. Give it a thumbs up and thanks for watching, guys. Bye.